Hey there, and welcome back, BMATs. I hope your minds haven't reached cutoff just yet, because we've got a brand new fully charged rewind video just for you. Today, you learned a lot about transistor amplifiers and their different configurations, so I hope you're charged up and ready to burn through this daily rewind. Now let's actually get into what we're here to talk about, amplifiers. All right, the purpose of an amplifier is to increase signal strength. We're going to say that a million times in class. Do not worry about it. But before we really get into their configuration, let's talk class of operation for a minute. When I'm talking about class of operation, we only teach three different ones. There's a whole lot more than that, but we're only going to teach three. The first one is class A operation. So if you have a transistor, and in this class, it has greater than 0.6 volts on the base, it's operating in class A operation. And that means that if we bring in a full sine wave, we're going to get a full sine wave out. It has the highest fidelity. The next one is class B operation. In class B operation, you're only going to have exactly 0.6 volts on the base. So when we bring in a full AC sine wave, we're only going to get half of a sine wave on the output. And lastly, operating in class C mode of operation, we'll have less than 0.6 volts on the base. With that, we bring in a full sine wave, we're only getting less than half of a sine wave on the output. Now let's move on to my favorite of the amplifier configurations that's near and dear to my heart, the common emitter amplifier. The common emitter amplifier is going to have an input on the base and the output is going to be taken from the collector. Which terminal did we not talk about? That's right, the emitter. So that's why the emitter is common to the base and the collector. The key trait of the common emitter amplifier circuit is that the output is going to be 180 degrees out of phase with the input, and you'll see in a minute when we actually bring in an AC signal. When we bring in AC, the signal eventually is going to alternate positive on the base. When this happens, we're going to increase forward bias at the base emitter junction, and from what you learned in class, you should remember that anytime we do that, emitter current goes up, and if emitter has 100% current, that means base and collector current also increase. If we have more current flowing through our collector resistor, or RC, it's going to have a greater voltage drop. If it's dropping more voltage, that means what's left over for the collector is less. And since the output's taken from the collector, the output signal also goes down, creating a negative alternation. See that phase difference? It's already 180 degrees out of phase. Now, the AC signal coming in is eventually going to alternate negative. When this happens, we're going to decrease forward bias at the base emitter junction, which in turn is going to decrease current flow, and less current flow through our collector resistor means that its voltage drop is going to go down, leaving more voltage for the collector, which is also our output signal. Look at that nice AC sine wave we've created. And since we're amplifying AC, we need to talk about voltage gain, or AV. Make sure you remember your formula, E out, or voltage out, divided by E in, voltage in. That's going to give you your AV, and remember, pro tip, if you put a voltage symbol or a unit of measurement on the end of your AV, you're going to be wrong every time. AV is just a multiplier. Now let's move on to the next amplifier configuration, the common collector amplifier. The common collector amplifier is pretty cool. It has an input on the base and an output on the emitter. Which terminal did we not talk about? If your answer is collector, you're probably correct. A key trait of the common collector amplifier is that it has an AV of 1. So, pro tip, if I ever ask you to calculate the AV on a common collector, all you gotta do is tell me 1. Another thing is that it is a current amplifier, so we're not gonna see much voltage amplification, but we are gonna see that current amplification. So let's bring in some AC and watch how this works. If I bring in positive alternation, we're gonna increase forward bias, kinda like what we did before. And doing that is gonna increase emitter, base, and collector current. We have more current flowing through R3, it's gonna have a greater voltage drop. And R3 also develops our output signal, so we're gonna develop a positive alternation. Notice that with the common collector, it is in phase with the input. Now when the AC signal coming in alternates negative, we're gonna decrease forward bias of the base emitter junction. We're gonna decrease current flow. We're gonna decrease current flow through R3 as well, which is gonna have a decreased voltage drop. And it's responsible for developing our output signal, so we're gonna see a negative alternation on the output in phase with our input. Now, let's move on to our last amplifier configuration, the common base amplifier. All right, for the common bass amplifier, you're gonna see an input received on the emitter, and the output is gonna be taken from the collector. But notice, we have a voltage divider network, R1 and R2, and C1 on the bass. That means the bass voltage is gonna stay the same. Hence why it's called a common bass amplifier. And C1's gonna prevent any AC from being developed there. It's a bypass capacitor. Now let's look at a key trait of the common bass amplifier. It's gonna have a large voltage gain, so you're gonna be able to tell it's a common bass simply by how big the AV is. Now, let's actually bring in some AC. When the AC signal on the emitter alternates positive, that bass voltage stays the same. So as that signal alternates positive, that 0.6, 0.7 gap between the bass and emitter that we need for this transistor to conduct is getting smaller. That's why the forward bias is going down. As the forward bias goes down, emitter, bass, collector current goes down, which means that there's less current going through our collector resistor, R3, which means that the voltage level on the collector is going to be increasing. So our output signal is going to go positive. And look at that large voltage gain we got on the collector there. Now, the incoming AC is going to alternate negative. This time, when it alternates negative, the forward bias is going to increase. The current flow emitter base to collector is going to increase. More current flowing through our collector resistor R3, it's going to have a greater voltage drop, which is going to leave less voltage on the collector, which is why our output signal alternates negative. And again, large voltage gain. Speaking of voltage gain, make sure you remember your formula, because with the common bass amplifier, you do have to know how to calculate AV. So remember, E out divided by E in. And do not put a unit of measurement on that AV. I promise you'll be wrong every single time. And with that being said, thanks again for listening today. Be sure to hit that like and subscribe button. And more importantly than that, make sure you review yesterday's material, since your first progress check is tomorrow morning. And remember, in the words of an old MTI of mine, if you're gonna mess up right. BMET, out.